Students, last class we study about what is cell, history of cell and different types of microscope. Today we are going to proceed with next topic, cell theory. Cell theory is based on the concept of three scientists, Sclerin, Skewen and Virchow. They are given their postulates to cell theory. The three basic components of the cell theory are: all organisms are composed of one or more cells. The cell is the basic unit of life in all living things. So these are the two postulates which is given by Sclerin and Skewen. Next, third one, all cells are produced by the division of pre-existing cell, that is the cells which are formed in the pre-existing cells. Okay, so this is given by Virchow. Cell facts. Cells vary in shape and size. The nerve cell is the longest cell in our body. It can be about 1 meter long. Ostrich egg is the largest cell. In human, the red blood cell corpuscles, okay, cells is otherwise called as corpuscles, are the smallest cell in the human body, and female ovum is the largest cell in the human body. Some organisms may be made up of single cell, that is unicellular organisms, others are multicellular. Proper division of labor is seen in multicellular organisms as different organ perform different function. But in unicellular organisms, the single cell perform all the functions. So these are the facts about cell. So what is the shape and size of the cell? It depends upon the cell which differs. Okay. Size and shape, it differs the thing. Cells differ in shape and size. This depends on the function, okay, that performed in it. The following illustration shall indicate how the structural variation helps in performing the function they are specialized for. For example, so here I just given some of the example like cell type, cell shape and cell function. So this we will discuss in briefly in chapter next according chapters. Cell type. Smooth muscles are spindle shape. It does a function called contraction and relaxation. Red blood corpuscles, discoid in shape and it carry respiratory gases. Egg cell, hard spherical in shape, it helps in food storage. Sperm cells are linear, flagellated, it helps in motile and swimming, it does a function like locomotion. Bone cell, circular with irregular projections. Skeletal framework, okay, there's a function called skeletal framework. Nerve cells are linear thread-like and it carry the impulses. So these are the tissue which is present inside the bird, okay, birds. So this we will discuss in the upcoming chapters. So these are the tissues, okay, different types of tissues. Actually, why I shown this picture here? See, a cell is a structural and functional unit of living organisms. A group of cells, that is one or two cells, are result in tissue. The tissue, a group of tissues which undergo the organ, which the organ which is responsible due for some function, okay, it responding to the stimulus, and that is called organ system. So from the cell to the tissue to the organ system. So these are called level grade of organization. Okay. So based on the level grade, cellular grade of organization, tissue grade of organization, organ grade of organization and organ system grade of organisms. Okay. So this we will discuss later. So here I just given the example of human cells, neuron, red blood cells, smooth muscle cells, columnar epithelial cells, white blood cells are some of the example of human cells. So here, you just experiment in your own with the onion peel, okay? You just take one onion and you just divide it into two off, and later you just take a peel of the onion, okay? And when you observe this peel under the microscope, you can see the rectangular structures in microscopes. It performs all life functions like intake of food material, excretion, metabolism, respiration, irritability, etc. So each cell will performing the functions like food material, excretion, metabolism, respiration, irritability. So these all you see under the human system. There will be like circulatory system, respiratory system, excretory system. So all the system which is undergone in each of the cells too. Division of labor. Cell usually possess a number of components called cell organelles. So each cell organelle perform different functions. Clearing waste material, protein synthesis, lipid synthesis. Cell is the basic unit of life. So these are we studied in cell organelles. Okay. In next upcoming videos, we will study about cell organelles. So types of cell. Depends upon the presence or absence of well-defined nucleus, the cells are of two types. One is prokaryotic cell, another one is eukaryotic cell. So the pro, which means primitive. Karyotic, karyon, it means nucleus. The cell which have the primitive nucleus is called prokaryotic cell. It means the cell which have the nucleus, but there will be no nuclear membrane or nucleolus present in the prokaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell, U, it means true. The word refers true. Karyotic again, karyon means nucleus. True nucleus, which you can see in cells. It means the nucleus is made up of nuclear membrane. Inside the nuclear membrane, there is well-defined nucleolus. Okay, so these full structure, okay, when you see the dense cytoplasm which is present inside the nucleus and the outer membrane, inner membrane, and there will be the nucleolus structure, chromatin networks. So all the well-defined nucleus you can see only in eukaryotic cell. So comparison of prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. So organisms, prokaryotic like eubacteria and archaebacteria. Here eukaryotes, protists, fungi, plants and animals. Level of organization, here is single cell, that is unicellular. In eukaryote, it has both single cell and multicellular, that is unicellular as well as the multicellular, usually with the tissues and organs. Typical cell size, small 1 to 10 microns. Here it's above the 10 to 100 microns. Cell wall, almost all cells have cell walls. Okay, here the cell walls refer murine. Here in fungi and plants, the cell wall is cellulose and chitin. And not in animals, because in animal cell, the cellulose, that the cell wall is absent. Organelles, usually none. But here in eukaryotes, there is specialized organs to function. Metabolism, anaerobic and aerobic diverse. Here in eukaryotes, mostly it will be aerobic. Okay. Genetic material, your single circular double strand DNA. Okay, here in eukaryotes, complex chromosomes usually in pairs, each with a single double stranded DNA molecule and associated protein contained in the nucleus. Mode of division, it undergo reproductions like binary fission, mostly like budding. Here in eukaryotes, it undergo cell division and cell reduction, that is mitosis and meiosis, using a spindle followed by cytokinesis. Here the term cytokinesis refer, kinesis is division of, and cytoplasm, so division of cytoplasm. So the term refers cytokinesis. So here you can see the prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. In prokaryotic cell, I just given you the example of bacteria, and in eukaryotic I just given the example of animal cells. So in prokaryotic you can see the outer cell wall. In eukaryotic there is absence of cell wall, and in prokaryotic there is no organelles you can found. Okay, so you can see only the ribosomes which is present in the prokaryote, but in eukaryote you can see the well defined organelles in eukaryotes like endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, nucleus and lysosomes and many other organelles too. Some unicellular organism. So the eukaryotic cell are of two type. One is unicellular and other one is multicellular. Here the term uni means what? Single. The animal or the organism which have the single cell is referred as unicellular organisms. Here the examples: paramecium, amoeba, bacteria, yeast. Okay, many of the protozoans comes under unicellular organisms. So what are all the characteristic of unicellular organisms? The unicellular organisms usually reproduce by asexual means. They can be eukaryotes or prokaryotes. They are found in almost all habitats from hot spring to frozen tundra. They possess whip-like structure for movement like flagella, cilia examples. The nutrients enter or leave the cell by the process of diffusion. So these are the characteristic of unicellular organism. Next we study about multicellular organism. It means the organism which has two or more cells are referred to multicellular. So here I just given two types of cells, that is the human and the plant, and here I shown the grades of organization. That is from the cell to tissue to the organ to the organism. So in animal I just taken the most primitive. Okay, the most upgraded animal is human, right? Homo sapiens. So I just taken that as an example. It starts from the cell, it forms a tissue and it forms an organ, and entire organism is you can see there. In plants it starts with the cell and you can see the tissue and you can see the organ and you can see the organisms. So these are the examples of multicellular organism. So what are all the characteristic of multicellular organisms? Here it is made up of more than one cell and are a complex organism. They are visible to the naked eye. They possess distinct organ and organ system. They are eukaryotes, that is they contain membrane, okay, bone structures. The cells exhibit division of labor. Their size increases with number of cells in an organism. So these are about the characteristic of multicellular organisms. In next class we will study about what are all the cell organelles which is present in the inside the cell. Thank you.